Hello everyone, good evening. As you guys know, last time we were here, finished off the main story, the main Black Dwarf. We fought and defeated the man behind of the damage that was being caused, Armstrong. And in this recording session, we will be going and the two DLCs that are in the game. The first one I'm going to do is the one about the Blade Wolf, our most beloved and faithful robotic companion that was with us for most of the game. This is where he was before Jack encountered him. It works kind of like Jack does. It is Y is the heavy attack, X is the light attack. They use up on the directional pad to use your senses. You can run. Do it not.
Kill your enemies in a single blow by approaching unnoticed from above or behind.
Well, not really senses, as well as like a radar. You can pull down RT, just like Jack does, to do a little run. Yes, I think he's a little bit faster than Jack, because he runs on all fours rather than just two legs. Jack, he can sneak up on people and stab them in the back. Those guys would not be in that exertion.
Through certain training scenarios over and over, or teach you that following orders absolves you of responsibility. Instill a fanatical belief in our cause that our enemies deserve death. Or perhaps can convince you that they aren't people at all. That they are less than human. That they are like animals. Things. I wonder which man would work best on you.
I possess neither man's killer instinct nor his moral urge to resist it. None of your methods would be effective.
Are you saying I cannot teach you any new tricks? Very well. Continue your training.
Yeah, most of this is VR trying.
Time for the practical combat training. Eliminate all cyborgs you find in the VR.
See, just like Jack, he can also take the nanites from the bad guys to heal himself.
Not bad. Keep it up.
It's like a dog version of Jack.
Your knives to damage enemies from afar. Yes? When you run and then you push the Y button, there's like a hurricane twist back.
Joining him on the next mission.
Buckle the fuck up, little doggy.
remember this. We're free in freedom here if it kills us, or better yet, them.
I would not know about freedom.
Then get ready for an education.
Let's see who gets the education.
Mistral, our mission is to spread freedom. If so, then why am I never offered a choice?
Why? Well, that's...
Oh, she just got an idea. Oh, that's not good. You just gave her an idea.
For this simulation, we have recreated the mission area in VR. Head to the target indicated on your map.
Okay. I would say easy enough, but all these guys running around, not so easy. Now, just like in, no, not now, because we're in a VR training at the moment, but just like in the main story, there actually are VR training mission computers. Not right now, of course, considering we're in a VR mission at the moment. I was right in his face and he didn't see me. Wow. Seems like no matter how I go up there, I'm gonna get spotted. Because there's a guy right there. And then there's that big gorilla thing right there. And this guy on the stairs. Yeah, I'm gonna get spotted no matter what. Hello. It's like he doesn't move from that spot. works for me. Good thing for me, that was the only one who spotted me. He was up by himself. Care about those sort of machines because I want to. I love sneak killing. In games. In real life, no. No. I would never do that. I would never kill anybody. Okay, I did not see this one. Well, it doesn't matter. Nobody's gonna see that guy.
Not bad. I will give you your next set of orders when you reach your objective.
Stop getting your panties in a twist. I go as fast as I like. There's another one on me. There you go. I gotta fight myself. Health upgrade. Nice. I bet myself I get a health upgrade. Climbing. Jumping. Stuff like that. But before I did that, I went to get the monkeys out of the way. I see you. Ooh, there's another one. Didn't even see me coming. Might want to turn around there, buddy. Never mind. I said, ah, look, I got hurt, but no, I didn't get hurt. I just got. Oops, wrong button. There we go. Not that good. Oh, no, wait, fuel upgrade. Never mind. That was a fuel upgrade. Alright. I'm done with all the pests. I mean, we can get to climbing, get to jumping, which apparently he's not good at. Yeah, you got 4 paws. You can't tell me you can't jump. That distance. This is ridiculous. Oh, he jumped over the block. So you were able to jump that distance. Why can't you jump that distance? Oops. And I ran right off the block. I'm not doing this for good. There we go. Finally got on top of it. Oh, pfft. Just when I finally got on top of it, I missed the block that's moving. Doing a very good job jumping, am I? So I'm supposed to get up there. Oh, that's why I'm jumping on the wrong blocks. My bad. Why does his tail constantly have to twirl and swirl like that? Might get your wish there with the rope free robot. Cause you just got caught. Or were you asking him if he wished to know what pain is? Can robots feel pain? Because as you guys know, pain comes from nerve centers, which are attached to the brain, and then robots don't have those nerve centers, then they obviously can't feel pain. Well, he wanted him to learn, so he learned.
LQ-84I has gone AWOL. Destroy it.
One tough door. It was like slashing at it and everything. Nope, that door wouldn't budge. Oh, health upgrade. Thank you very much. Making sure I'm not messing. There's not anything in here that I need to grab. And this is where we met Jack. Let's see. Oh! Hey, boys! You're back! I just went in there to check to see if there was any goodies in there, and some more boys came out of nowhere. Oh great, we got flying ones. Cool. I've never done that before. That was a first. Okay, I almost didn't see that third flying one. It's a cat. It's a kitty cat. Oops. I need to angle that just right. There we go. Ooh, another fuel upgrade. Thank you very much. Now, this is not a simulation, by the way. This is reality.
Thank you.
You can even sneak kill these little robots too. Remember the hands. Arms. See, I'm better at sneak kills with this guy than I am better with Jack. Uh-oh. I shouldn't speak too soon. See how far this thing goes. It wasn't the thing that spotted me, it was the dude. Dude, you ruined my sneak attack. I was doing so good until I got spotted right there. See, this is what happens when you speak to your son, you end up jinxing yourself.
Ahead is an electromagnetic barricade. It uses the EMP wave to disable any UG or cyborg that tries to cross. Unless you are a contractor with the proper access code, of course. Now what? Kill a contractor and take his access code, perhaps? A pity little pets like yourself aren't given the code, hmm?
Ooh, she said that on purpose. You could tell by her attitude, the way she talked. She actually was literally giving me the answer. Now, I can't tell that guy over there in the corner. You see that guy in the corner? I can't tell which direction he's actually facing. Yeah, I couldn't tell which direction he was facing, and as I was the result, I didn't get spotted. Oh well. It was fun while it lasted, doing sneak kills.
To the coast, to freedom? Ha! Let me save you time. You won't make it. Just give up now, while you still can.
Oh, this is where we're meant to check. okay, here we go. The first, you see the one, the VR missions that Jack finds, you have an option. You don't have to do them. But in this one, you actually have to do them. Because every time you do them, you get a health upgrade. You're just a double ganger, okay? You're nothing compared to the original. Where'd the other one go? There you are. So I had camera? Won't work. Oh, it wasn't drawing anything at me. It was shooting me. Oh, of course, the stealth kills are called hunt kills. That's what they're called in this in the DLC. There's a little box up here. With a nice little health upgrade. Nice. I'm not actually sure how many of these VR simulator or computer things there are in this one. I'm surprised there's nobody up here on the second floor. Oh, that's Patricia. Did I jinx myself again? I think I might have. Was on the second floor, but he jumped down. Not close enough. Thank you. Damn it! I figured if I get distracted with that little hologram there, I could sneak up from behind and kill it that way, but it didn't work like I wanted it to. I do love these upgrades I'm getting. Health upgrades, fuel upgrades. There it is. Those are backs are soft as a ball. Data stores. Apparently they're in this one too. And just like in the main store, most likely I will not be getting them all. Thank you. Alright, next simulation. I remember really this one. It's a two-dimensional. I was thinking this is a sneaky rat, but no, this is a two-dimensional one. Oh, and I fell. Ooh, let's try. Missed some more. Bye-bye. Okay, look at that little hand robot doing his little clap in there. Clapping no more. Oh! Okay, I admit those explosives took me by surprise. And I go and just jump on them. That's good. Good idea. Just if in doubt, just jump on him. I was trying to jump over them, but it didn't work. I got out of that chair. But I still completed the objective. I wish my health upgrade. What? No health upgrade this time? Well, that was mad. I almost did not see that guy. And lucky he wasn't smart enough to look around the corner. Thank you. fuel up. Thank you very much. That's always help, I guess, helpful. But health upgrade would be much better. Yeah, you're using a machine to fight. At least the other two have the balls to fight themselves and not use a machine to do their job for them. You can't get out of that. I was pushing buttons and everything. Oh, I did get out of that. How did I get out of that?
No, I can't move.
I don't know how I got out of that. I think I know how I did it. I briefly hit blade mode. That's because I was just smashing buttons, and I think when I hit RB, which is blade mode, that's what got me out of it. I think you just did.
No.
That's your butt. That, ladies and gentlemen, is Wolf's story. There was a few more simulators in that DLC, but I don't exactly know where all their locations are. So, oh well. Alright. That is it for the first DLC, the Blade Wolf. Coming up next is the second DLC, which is about Sam. I should really skip these, because we already seen this. No? No, no skippage? Okay. Looks like we can't skip the credits. That's nice. Because all these same means are rather these credits. But they're forcing you to see them again. Mm-hmm. Well, as you guys could tell in that DLC, there was supposed to be another Wind of Destruction. It wasn't just the two. It was supposed to be three of them. Three members of the Winds of Destruction. But Blade Wolf killed one of them. And it was all her, idea. She pretty much let Blade Wolf go and do what he wanted. Just so that he would kill the other one. It was all part of her plan.